Okay, you guys, I can feel it. Energy is low, you know. Caffeine is not enough, but, you know, we'll power through this. Okay, so I'm going to talk to you about programmable air. Before I go into that sufficiently intriguing title, let me do this. So that's me, circa 2010. Now that I have sufficiently embarrassed myself, nothing else that I do matters. So that is also me on the same day. And I'm holding an unknown piece of electronic. There's a thing here with like a bunch of things. So I'm one of you guys, you know. But when I went to college, I thought that physics is way more interesting. But then when physics got to quantum Hamiltonian, I said, you know what, making things is way more interesting. And so I became the engineering consultant for the ecology department. I made a wind tunnel. I made a tachometer to measure insect wing beat frequencies. I made an elephant height sensor. This thing right there is a 6.5-foot PCB, and that's the small version. I made two of the 13-foot PCBs, and that took me about a dozen movies to solder. Then I got bored of that, so I made an electric skateboard that was better than a boosted board back then. Then I moved to a startup. I tried to make the new laser tag, ran out of money, moved to a hardware startup, made a laser scanning thingy for box size measurement, and then moved to New York, ITP. Yay! There I put LEDs and sensors inside concrete, and I made magnetic concrete sculptures. But don't worry, I didn't go too far into the artistic side. I made a concrete stand for my soldering iron, and I put foldable PCB headphones on a punk monk. But then, you guys, something happened that changed my life. I met Carrie Love, and I took a class on soft robotics. Carrie, thank you so much. This project would not have been possible without you. Soft robotics, if you don't know, is an up-and-coming field. These are all inflatable robots that allow you to do, like, you know, things like grip tomatoes, which are very difficult to do with like gears and servos and stuff. And you know what the thing about soft robotics is that with 3D printing and silicone casting, it's pretty darn easy to make top-shelf soft robots in your home lab. But what makes it difficult is, so for example, Aiden here is a high school student in New York, and he makes soft robots like this one that inspire graduate students in Yale. Like, what up? But the thing that makes it difficult is that the tools for controlling these robots are not available. For example, these are the two things that are kind of the only two things that are sort of kind of available. This guy is not commercially available, and this guy is from Harvard. So I shouldn't be bashing it too much here, but that's a breadboard. I'm not calling that a product. By researchers, for researchers. So I said, you know, fudge that. I'm going to make something for the hobbyist maker. So it has to be cost effective. It has to be easy to set up. And I had an inkling that vacuum was going to be big, so it should support vacuum. So what I did, you guys, is that I looked at over 200 spec sheets for pressure sensors. The thing with pneumatics is that when you're designing a PCB, like you can design it with your voltage and your circuit and your current regulation. With pneumatics, you get the pressure, you get the flow rate, you get the nozzle size. God damn the nozzle size. So, you know, I ordered like dozens and dozens of components. I made schematics. I made the layout, you know, other mill, made the PCB. By the way, curved traces, you guys. Get with the curved traces. And I made this thing, and lo and behold, nothing worked. So it's been a few iterations since that. Let's see how we're doing now. Let me plug this guy in. One, two, three. You guys, let me introduce you to Mr. Piggy. Mr. Piggy is generally a squeaky toy, but today he's controlling these lights. So light press, hard press, right? You have a pressure sensor in there, no wires. But the thing with air that I like is that it's scalable. You can take this, wrap that around, make that into a tube, and wrap that around your bumper car. For the price of one pressure sensor, you have an impact detector for your irregularly shaped car. Over here, we have a balloon that's slowly breathing, right? Now that may look tame to you, but the thing is that you have a single tube going in that allows you to push air into the balloon, read the pressure and hence the size of the balloon, and suck air out of it. This is not venting to the atmosphere, this is sucking the air back with a vacuum pump. So how does that work? The way it works is you have your motor, you have your vacuum pump, these are valves, balloon, pressure sensor, the legend is on the right. So here, by switching on this valve, you're pushing air in. By switching on this valve, you're sucking air out. By switching on this valve, you're exchanging air with the atmosphere. And I'm calling this full air channel control, OK? Let's see what else you can do with this thing. So I have here a balloon filled with coffee and a little 3D printed handle. Now, OK, this is going to be tough because I have to hold the mic and press a button as well. Let's try this. OK. Yep, thank you very much. So here, this is nice and soft. Press a button, and it sucks a vacuum. This becomes practically a solid. It's soft again, and now it's a solid. So what that allows me to do is pick up a penny. Whoops. God damn. Pick up a penny from a flat surface. It works. OK, sort of. But show me an industrial robot that can pick up a penny and pick up the badge. God damn, I swear this was working. Ah, OK. You know, it sort of works. The badge is a bit hard, but OK. all right. So and the thing is, you guys, this is modular, right? So I have this board over here, which has the pumps on it, and the Arduino Nano clone, because I don't have money. and this guy here has three valves and the pressure sensor. That's all that is required for the full air channel control. And the thing is modular. So you have the Arduino and the pump, and then you can add up to three of these valve and pressure boards to your single Arduino. And with just digital read and analog digital write and analog read, you can control up to three air channels. You know, all three demos could be running on the single board. It's modular in the sense that there's an Arduino Nano instead of a microcontroller soldered to the board. So I can swap the microcontroller. Excuse me, Mr. Piggy, I'm going to use this guy over here. And now this is a soft robot from OpenSoft Labs based in University of Tokyo. And you know, that's an actuator. It took me about 2 minutes to write that code. It's all digital read and digital write and analog read, but you know what? I thought that was too complicated, so I made a software, the library. So it, basically, that's all the functions that you have. There's a few more Easter eggs, but let's not go into there. It's all on the GitHub. I have put in paragraphs and paragraphs of my failures and the few successes, as well as my vendor sources, price, everything. I try to make it as easy as possible to not have me make a business out of it. Programmability.com will guide you to the GitHub and Hackaday and everything. So you know, I made this thing, got some press, and I was like, I've had my 5 minutes of fame, time to move to something else. But what happened was my friend Kim approached me. She's an artist, and she wanted to make Ada Foxy Lovelace. Foxy Lovelace is a sculpture that accentuates the female lips, and it's an artistic statement. The idea is that it has these ample lips, but as you try to approach it, it blows a bubble, and it doesn't let you touch the lips. I'm not quite sure I understand the artistic. I'm sure Kim could explain it way better. Yeah, but it sucks the balloon back into the lips, and from when you can't see that there's going to be a balloon. You really can't do it without pneumatics. Okay. So I was like, you know what? This is interesting. People want to use it. So from here and here over the summer, I went to here and here and here. And then I presented at the Maker Faire, which was absolutely stunning because kids just loved it. Kids are the best user testers. Like, they figured out things that I couldn't with a vacuum gripper. Like, and adults who act like kids are just as good, actually. so I got some more. This guy wanted to make cosplay. I'm looking at Joe. Wanted to make a soft cosplay. You know, if you want to do that, that's cool. Got a ribbon. I was like so excited. Oh my god. Thank you, DC. It got some press, which was absolutely stunning, and that was this weekend. So what's next for programmable layer? So now what's happening is that I want to push 50 units by Halloween and get it into the hands of makers so that they can make something interesting with it. I'm right now hand assembling these things, so I really should be back home soldering these things because, right? So why am I here? The thing is that I don't know anything about electronics manufacturing. I'm kind of, yeah. So if you have a pick and place machine, wink, wink, nod, nod, maybe approach me. If you have, the thing is, I know I'm going to make a dozen mistakes when I make these 50 units, but I hope they won't be the same dozen mistakes that you guys made when you made your 50 units. So if you have anything to tell me, like Dumbo, I'm all ears. Thank you so much. It was great talking to you. These demos are, of course, going to be here to play with.